So I'll just say a few things. One is, I'm basically from Tamil Nadu, okay? So my Hindi is like little patchy, but I can really understand Hindi, but I can't speak really fluently. So aap sawal pooch sakte hain, par I will actually try to understand, answer in English. Okay, and if anybody can ask in Tamil, I can understand, answer in Tamil. Vanakkam. Thank you. Okay, so second thing is, right now I run a news company called Glance Media, which actually takes news from all over the world and actually condenses into three small bullet points and presents it in Hindi. Okay, so like by this way, what I feel was, the Hindi audience is not being treated properly, like they're not getting quality news compared to the English audience. So we want to get the, for example, if there's a news in say Wall Street Journal or Guardian or Sydney Morning Herald, whatever it is, you don't get that heavy news or informative news in Hindi. So we are trying to work towards that. So I'll just interview Dr. Vinay Sahasrabuddhe, and I want to play a short clipping from that interview, which I think is relevant to this whole function, okay? I think what I am going to talk is something that can actually supplement what you have, what has been like discussed so far. So though this, though the topic given to me is like role of media and ICT, I will actually dwell a lot on media. Okay, ICT will come later, if time permitting. I am doing this because planning for media, especially during elections, is actually a very, very critical activity. And this is, that's where like most of the budget, that the crazy numbers that you see on election expenditure from parties actually go there. And it is also like a very skill intensive exercise. Like you need like people who can really understand how it works. There are a lot of nitty gritties, and especially in a country like India where like so many languages are spoken, the local peculiarities have to be taken care of, so on and so forth. I'll go into all of this, and I'm going to actually use a lot of original slides that I actually had made during the 2014 campaign, which I was a part of. So some of them actually like turned out a little bit different than what is in the presentation, but I just wanted to give you an overview of how we thought about it when we thought about it. So so that's how things are going to be. So if you have any questions so far, like please ask me. Otherwise, I'll go to the presentation. Good? Okay. Okay, how do I...
Please go to the slideshow.
That's fine. Technology.
Oh, this one, okay. Okay, so this is going to be most of what I'm going to talk today, okay? So why? Basically because of the wide reach of mass media. Now, very educated people like us, actually like we have access to social media and we think social media is the world. But there is there's a whole host of people, like a vast majority of people actually can still consume news through big media. By big media, I mean TV, radio, print, cinema, so on and so forth, outdoor advertising, so on and so forth. And another fascinating feature is like many, a substantial portion of population in places like in states like Bihar, Orissa, and Uttar Pradesh are media dark. In fact, they don't consume information through any of these sources. Okay, so when you actually like plan for an election, like you have to take into consideration all of this. Okay, if there are regions where media reach itself is actually very less, how do you actually like go and reach out to those people? Okay, so there are lot of variables that have to be taken care of. So why we are talking about this, it is like wide reach requires extensive planning and meticulous execution, and scope in terms of communication channels, languages, etc. is mind-boggling. Languages, like needless to say, we know how our country is, like, and especially dialects, so on and so forth. For example, like an ad that is made in Hindi cannot actually be really understood by, say, somebody that speaks Bhojpuri. Like, we have to actually like tweak it. It's not, I'm not talking about like Tamil versus Hindi. I'm talking about like Bhojpuri versus Braj, so on and so forth. Right, and also communication channels, it's like, it's the number of ways in which you can communicate even within the same medium is like, is unbelievable. For example, just take TV, okay? TV, like, you need to have a particular kind of ad for, say, that has to be played between a Saas Bahu series, okay? Or like, you know, a different kind of ad to be had has to be played in channel B, okay? Then there are like, you know, outdoor advertising, there are OOH, like, you know, if you eat in restaurants, there's a TV that actually plays these quizzes, so on and so forth. That is a new medium, okay? In theaters, in intervals, there are actually like, you can play ads. Okay, so like what I'm trying to say is like, there are very many kinds of ways in which you can reach people at that particular point of time, and each one has to be customized. You cannot just like create an ad and actually play it everywhere, okay? So that requires a lot of planning. And another thing is like, this all happens within a span of 3-4 crazy months, okay? It's like absolutely crazy with a capital C, okay? Because like, you have to do all of this, you handle a large amount of resources, and also you have to actually negotiate with external vendors who you usually hire. For example, like, you hire a creative agency to actually make the creatives. Okay, so on and so forth. And there are actually like calls that will be taken by leaders at some point. Sometimes like you make an ad and you're going to release, but a senior leader would say like, don't run this, this won't work well, so on and so forth. And there has to be like a negotiating process as well. Sometimes like, you have to make the leader understand like why we actually thought about it in the first place, so on and so forth. There's political management, short period of 4-5 months. In the US, actually, this happens over a period of 2-3 years, okay? In fact, like, the 2 years is what it takes, actually, to build a whole campaign. But we actually do it in 3-4 months. So, yeah, as I said, like, the resource spent is close to an annual turnover of a mid-sized Indian company. Okay, I'm not giving the numbers, but, you know, you can understand the size. It's actually pretty huge. So, why should I talk about it? And actually, I wanted to talk about it because, like, in 2014, I was very keenly, closely involved with the publicity campaign. I pretty much like went from like scratch. Actually, where we were shown a piece of land to say this is where your office is going to be, until like the whole thing panned out. So I there is this except social media, which is handled by the IT cell of BJP. I pretty much looked at everything that actually went through. Like any ad that you would have seen on TV, seen on print, or seen on outdoor would have actually gone through my team. So this was the campaign vision. This was created sometime, I think, in January or February. January of 2014. So what would be, like, how do you want the campaign to pan out? So we wanted to run a national campaign, like a local campaign. Okay, with close voter contact, but with a centralized control and strategy. Okay, so because otherwise, like, if you don't have a centralized control and strategy, like, the message dissipates. Okay, so we need to have a unified way of sending out the message, also reinforcing, so on and so forth. Okay, so so this was the strategy, that is the vision, but how to actually execute that vision is something else. So we'll actually run bottom-up campaigns. Unlike the top-down campaigns of the past, okay? So this is something probably done first time in India, okay? So I'll tell you usually how things happen. So assume, in previous campaigns that I have not actually worked in the publicity department of those campaigns, but I've actually closely followed them. So usually what happens is they actually say, okay, you have X amount of money to spend on actually all this on media, okay? So then the campaign director actually says, okay, of this X, like, let's put some on TV, let's put some on radios, let's put some on print, let's put some on outdoor. And again, then, like, you know, they will find out, like, which agency will do what, so on and so forth, okay? This is called the top-down strategy. You have the money, you have the resources, then you actually see how to reach people, okay? So this has been historically how it has been done, but it's actually, like, probably the most ineffective way of doing it. But, like, I mean, because in olden days, like, media was actually, we had very less resources. Also, like, there was actually no real strategic thinking about, like, how to go about with media execution, so on and so forth. So this time, like, we actually totally converted it, okay? So we actually did a bottom-up campaign. So we decided, like, you know, who are the main voters that we need to target, okay? There's no point in, like, doing a big campaign for BJP in Gujarat, for example, okay? So we can actually, like, segment voters on many, many categories, like gender, location, age, probably, like, if they live in a poor district or in a comparatively wealthier district, so on and so forth. So we actually did a lot of segmentation, okay? But predominantly the main segments we tried to target was, like, women and youth, okay? That actually was the major theme, because our leaders actually were very keen on actually targeting those voters, mainly because especially a lot of young people were coming into the
Congress party. Ne Congress ka haath aam aadmi ke saath, fir wo aam aadmi idhar aa gaya aur Gandhi topi bhi idhar aa gayi, aam aadmi party aa gayi. BJP ka bhi narrative kya tha, acche din aane wale hain. To ye sari kahani jo hoti hai election campaign ki na, bahut simple, sabka saath sabka vikas. 2009 mein BJP ka slogan aapko pata hai kya hai, bolne mein दिक्कत हो जाएगी, क्या था? सशक्त नेता निर्णायक सरकार, सशक्त नेता निर्णायक सरकार. आज हिंदुस्तान में 80 साल के आदमी को अनुभवी तो कहते हैं लेकिन सशक्त नहीं मानते, हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर कैंडिडेट अडवाणी जी के, तो ना मजबूत नेता, हाँ मजबूत तो नहीं होते मानते ना, हिंदुस्तान में 80 साल का आदमी मजबूत नहीं होता. तो जो नैरेटिव है ना,
दो साल से सरकार अपना काम कर रही है और जिम्मेदारी के साथ कर रही है. आपकी तरह फारूक साहब के साथ डिस्को नहीं करते हैं, आपके लिए डिस्को नहीं की तरह हम नहीं करते हैं.
कैसे
भाई, ओके, या सो द थिंग इज लाइक द आर्गुमेंट इज नॉट देयर, इट्स
लाइक जस्ट जोक, इसको
थोड़ा सा ले जाना मैं सही आर्गुमेंट का. ओके, सी दिस इज आल्सो लाइक इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट जस्ट आई जस्ट दिस इज
सब्जेक्ट के बहुत सारे फ्रेंड्स होते
हैं. But the thing is, this is also something that a media planner should keep in mind, because like slogans trigger emotions, okay? And when you actually create a slogan, you actually have to like look at it from a balcony, you know, you have to see how it will act. And for that, you need to have a dispatch tape mind, okay? So like that is actually very important, very hard to do, but like good creative people actually.
Kitna charge ho gaya maa. Now everybody will listen to you very carefully. They want me pehle charge kiya tha, wo bhi
important. Okay, like it's not for me to tell, but it's okay. So I'll just go through. I'll actually show you a few tables as well. Okay, and this will take you back to 2 years ago, which is actually a good feeling for me. So so this is how it actually goes. Okay, most campaigns we see, this is kind of a template, okay? Unless like somebody like starts very, very late, okay? Unless like, you know, for example, in our Assam campaign recently, we actually started there, okay? So probably like we actually touched like a bit there and we went totally to third phase. The wealth plan campaign is only this, okay? You actually initially create a very negative perception about like what is happening, especially like if you are in the opposition. There will be like great anger and sadness. If you actually like look at our campaign, it will be like, Janta maaf nahi karegi. Like this is huge Godala wala ads, you know, Billy Sarpani ads, so it will be like the template to achieve it. Okay, like what will be the new tool, okay, or what is probably done in Gujarat, okay, which is probably an equivalent thing. Okay, the third will be like the inspirational book thing where actually there will be like this huge anthem that will be played, Desh Nahi Mitne Dunga, Taika, whole thing. Okay, so it all actually flow together. When actually, like, when they're close to vote, like there will be this, you know, we hope that at least like people will carry all the baggage. You know, there will be like great anger towards the existing setup, and there will be like a whole huge hope that actually they take it to the voting group. So all you can plan creative distribution strategy anywhere you want, but unless there is this huge emotional content in your thing, your creative nothing there, because like we are all human beings, we actually like respond to emotion. This is great fascination between everybody here with me. So this great fascination with doing stuff with sophisticated people, because like we see a lot of Horlicks ads, Travel Lovely ads, so on and so forth, and we actually get to that product. But we do not lose focus that this is about the individual, the common man that has to like that. So there will be a creative anthem that will encompass So yeah, so local language, local issues, there's a regional local split. I don't think we followed this, but anyway. So this is how we actually approach it. So managing creative agencies, right, it's actually very difficult, okay? I was told that you know Maniratnam and Ilayaraja? Maniratnam was the same director, like, won't budge from it. Okay, that's actually done. With creative agencies, that is the kind of challenge we face. Okay, they are not like 10-second geniuses, but like, you know, once something is set in the mind, okay, it actually becomes very creative, very difficult to actually change that. So there should be this like kind of nice balance between like how creative, how you can let them free at the same time get what you want. So there is this balance that depends on like the agency, the people that you work with, so on and so forth. So that is something that's very important. Usually like a lot of teams lose the plot in that. Okay, they actually allow the creative teams to do whatever they want, thinking that they are the experts, so on. But you ultimately you get a very a product that is not very satisfactory. Okay, so this is how we went about it. Like, so we actually had a good trust in the creative agency that was working with us. It was called Ogilvy and Mather, the best creative agency in India. So like we actually gave them a blank canvas. We actually told them what we needed.
So this was integrated into IPL. Okay, so there were like 10-15 creatives like this for IPL.
What I'm just looking at the newspaper, there are campaigns, there are all the systems set up. Our newspaper of our magazine name. How are you setting up? So, how are you going to stop?
That's true. But continue corruption, be you responsible.
What?
Of course. You responsible, who? तुम क्या बोल डालने जा रहे
हो?
क्या? अगर तुम वोट नहीं डालो तो चेंज कैसे आए? इकट्ठे करप्ट की करप्ट ही रहेगी।
अगर हमें कांग्रेस से करप्शन हटाना है, तो हमें वोट डालना होगा।
Exactly.
So look at this. This was actually it was not scripted by us. This was actually it happened in a TV show. And when they're talking about something like vote day, we actually put in this whatever. So this kind of signifies the detail, okay? So like we never left anything to chance. And actually, so see, look at this. This was like done in Urdu. It was actually, we published it in many Urdu newspapers. Probably this newspaper would have got it. I don't know whether it's Urdu Daily or Kashmiri, sir, Urdu. So probably you would have got this ad. Okay. So this is the thing. And also there is always this this is probably a great way to end. So this is. And with that hopeful note, I'll end the presentation. Okay, thank you very much.
This is an exceptional event organized by the Rambhau Mhalgi Prabodhini on training political leaders. It goes with the vision of recognizing that there are a lot of skills that are required for political leaders and activists. It involves communication skills, it involves policy skills, analytical skills, so on and so forth. And it is very important that there's a formal training program that is organized for activists. And I'm very happy that actually I'm being a part of this.